So today we discuss about the three phase delta connection. So as we discussed this in the class itself, in the case of delta connection, the relation between line voltage as well as phase voltage, similarly what the relation between line current and as well as the phase current. In the case of three phase delta connection, using the vector diagram already we derived that the amount of line voltage and the amount of phase voltage which are equal in value, and similarly the amount of line current which exactly equals to root 3 times of the phase current. Okay, so the VL is nothing but the line voltage. Line voltage is nothing but it is the voltage between any two lines. So as we already know, in the case of three phase connection, there are three terminals, that is R, Y, V. R means red, Y means yellow, V means B, that is blue. So here this any voltage between any two terminals or any two phases which represents the line voltage. Okay. And voltage across any one phase which represents the phase voltage. And here I am using the three ammeters to measure the individual line current, so that I can measure what the value of phase current using the formula of phase current is equal to line current divided by root 3. Okay. So this this box which represents the three phase auto transformer, for which a three phase electrical input I am giving as an input. Here R, Y, V which represents the three phase electrical supply which is getting from the KU. Okay. This is having 440 volts and 50 volts. So whatever the input voltage which I am giving for the auto transformer, and the output voltage that I can vary from 0 to 440. So initially I will keep the auto transformer position in the 0, and slowly by gradually I will increase the voltage till the rated voltage, that is equal to 440. So once if I apply the rated voltage to the given circuit diagram, and initially I will keep all the load which is connected in delta, which is in the 0 position. The maximum loading condition of the three phase delta which I am using here, it is having 10 ampere. So there are 10 individual switches I will have, that I will show in the circuit diagram. Okay. So now slowly, first initially by applying the voltage, I will measure all the 3 ammeter readings, what the value of current which I am getting. And after the giving supply voltage, slowly I will increase the amount of loading which is giving to this by using the toggle switches. I will just vary the from off condition to on condition, I will vary, and I will measure what current which is flowing individually in the respective phases. Okay. And this is what this diagram which explains you how the three phase delta connection which is made. Three phase, it is having totally 6 terminals. Here 2 terminals, here 2 terminals, here 2 terminals. That is A1, A2, B1, B2 and as well as C1, C2. The A1 is to be connected to B2. Similarly B1 is connected to C2 and A2 is connected to C1. Okay. So this is how the three phase delta connection which is made. See here, this is A1, A2. Okay. A1 is connected to B2. A1 is connected to B2. Similarly, here B1 have, B1 and C1 has to be connected. So same B1 and C2 has to be, B1 and another C2 have been connected in the respective diagram. So this is the diagram which explains us how the three phase delta connection is made. These are the individual relations what we have in the case of three phase delta connection, and this is what the circuit diagram using which how the connection has to be made. Now let us go through practical case. Now let us go through the practical case. So this box which is nothing but the three phase variac, using which we can apply the three phase voltage to the three phase 440 volts to the given circuit diagram. So here I am using the three ammeters as shown in the circuit diagram. That is in the circuit diagram I have shown. So three individual ammeters which will measures the individual respective currents which is flowing in the respective RY and as well as B phase. This is what the three phase load. So this maximum rating of this three phase load is 10 ampere. So this three phase load which is consisting of 10 switches. So each load which gives you the 1 ampere of loading, three phase loading. Okay. Now let me show the connections how we have been done. So the input to this variac which is given from the KV supply, that is input supply from the output which is available from the KV, which I am giving as input for the three phase auto transformer. Output of these three variables, that is from the auto transformer, whatever the three output variables which we have, R, Y, B, that output of these three which we need to give as input for the ammeter, and the output of the ammeter which we need to give as input for the three phase load. So from R phase to ammeter I have given as a first connection. Output of R phase which is given to the three phase load, R phase. Similarly Y phase output is given to the ammeter.
This is from our Y phase to ammeter. Output of ammeter from the Y phase, which is given to the Y phase of the 3-phase load. Similarly, from the B phase, output of the auto transformer, which is given to the ammeter of the B phase. Output of the ammeter, which is given to the 3-phase load B. Okay. And coming to the delta connection of this 3-phase load, this A1 which is connected to B2. And similarly, from this B1 to C2. So this is how we can make the 3-phase delta connection. And this is how the circuit diagram that we need to connect in the case of 3-phase delta connection. Now we will apply the 3-phase voltage using this 3-phase variac. So slowly we will increase by using this knob position, we will apply the 440 volts. After applying the 440 volts input voltage, we will measure all the, that is that 340 volts, 440 volts, how much we have applied, that is input voltage giving to the circuit, that we can measure by using this voltmeter. All the meters here I am supposed to use are of moving iron type of, why, because to measure the AC quantities, we are using the MI meters, okay. So all these are the MI meters only. So output voltage which is from the auto transformer, which I can measure by using this voltmeter. And slowly by after giving the voltage, now I will increase the amount of loading slowly, one by one. That is, first initially I will keep the 2 ampere of loading by increasing or by toggling this switch position to the on position, 2 on position. So now this shows 2 ampere of loading which I put onto the circuit. Now with this 2 ampere of loading, now there will be a deflection which is shown in the ammeter after giving the supply voltage. Now I will measure all the ammeter readings, and as well as I will measure the voltmeter reading, so that I will get the what the value of input voltage I am getting giving, and as well as what the current of flowing in the respective 3 phases. After that I can calculate the phase current by using the theoretical derivations which we have done. Thank you.